Chaos reigned within the castle's hallowed halls, a symphony of terror and violence conducted by the relentless werewolves. Moonlight seeped through shattered stained glass windows, casting macabre patterns upon the scene of horror. It was a canvas of crimson and darkness, where the screams of the wounded and dying painted an agonizing melody. Elara, her transformation complete, stood at the forefront of the savage onslaught. Her once compassionate eyes had given way to an insatiable hunger. Her lips curled into a snarl that exposed her glistening fangs. She moved with a grace that belied her monstrous form, a whirlwind of death that tore through the remaining guards. My heart ached as I beheld this grotesque transformation of the woman we had once known. Each strike she delivered was a painful reminder of the friend we had lost to the curse. But there was no time for mourning, for the castle's fate hung in the balance. The alpha werewolf, cunning and relentless, orchestrated the assault with ruthless precision. His pack, a nightmarish collection of lupine horrors, followed his lead. Their eyes, fiery orbs of malevolence, locked onto us with a feral hunger that sent shivers through our souls. Eric, the steadiest among us, met the alpha's gaze with a determined glare. His grip on his weapon tightened, his knuckles turning white as he prepared to confront the embodiment of our nightmare. Hans, the seasoned hunter, launched himself at a werewolf, their clash a blur of snarls and strikes. Blood sprayed in feral arcs as blade met fur, the outcome uncertain in the chaos. The scent of death and fear hung heavy in the air, a nauseating miasma that clung to every breath. It was a battle for survival, a fight to protect our village's last bastion of defense. Elara, her once beautiful face now contorted into a grotesque mask, lunged at me. Her claws grazed my cheek, leaving behind a searing pain that fueled my resolve. I could see a flicker of humanity in her eyes, a plea for release from the curse that bound her. With a heavy heart, I struck her down, my blade finding its mark. Her anguished howl pierced the night, a haunting lament for the life she had lost. But there was no time to dwell on sorrow. The alpha werewolf, sensing the tide of battle turning, let out a primal roar that reverberated through the castle. His pack, their eyes filled with a rabid hunger, retreated, their shadows melding with the darkness. We hunters, battered and bloodied, stood amid the wreckage, our breaths ragged and our hearts heavy with the cost of the battle. The castle, once a symbol of our kingdom's strength, now lay in ruins, a testament to the horror that had befallen us. The moon hung high in the sky, an unfeeling witness to our suffering. As we gathered our wounded and counted our losses, we knew that the battle was far from over. The alpha werewolf and his pack had tasted our kingdom's blood, and they would return, their hunger unquenched. With a heavy heart, I looked at the shattered visage of our beloved castle. Its grandeur had crumbled, and our kingdom's fate hung in the balance. The darkness that had enveloped us was far from defeated, and our struggle for survival would continue under the unforgiving gaze of the moon. Amid the ruins of the besieged castle, we hunters stood as guardians of the night, our battered forms silhouetted against the eerie glow of the moon. The air was thick with the stench of blood and the haunting echoes of our recent battle. We were wounded but undeterred, determined to protect our kingdom at any cost. In the heart of the chaos, King Frederick, the wise ruler of Ravenswood, had taken up arms alongside his loyal guards. His regal attire was stained with the blood of his fallen men, a testament to his unwavering resolve to defend his kingdom. His eyes, once filled with wisdom and kindness, were now ablaze with the fire of a leader facing his darkest hour. The alpha werewolf, a malevolent force that had orchestrated this nightmarish siege, closed in on the beleaguered king. His pack, a relentless tide of fur and fangs, moved with predatory grace, their crimson eyes locked onto their prize. As the alpha approached, King Frederick raised his sword, his every movement a testament to his valor. He faced the beast, unyielding in his determination to protect his people. His voice, a defiant roar, rallied his remaining guards to stand with him in this final, desperate stand. The clash was swift and brutal, a savage ballet of steel against fur and claw. King Frederick, a lion in the face of the encroaching darkness, fought with an unwavering resolve. His sword flashed in the moonlight as he struck blow after blow, each one a testament to his determination. But the Alpha Werewolf was a formidable adversary, his strength and cunning unmatched. With a swift, deadly strike, he disarmed the king, sending the sword clattering to the ground. In that moment, the fate of Ravenswood hung by a thread. The king, undaunted, faced his imminent demise with a courage that moved us all. With a defiant roar, he lunged at the Alpha, grappling with the monstrous foe. Their struggle was a gruesome spectacle, a clash of titans in the moonlit ruins. The Alpha Werewolf, driven by a hunger that knew no bounds, sank his fangs into the king's throat. A spray of crimson painted the stones beneath them as the monarch's life force was drained away. His eyes, once filled with wisdom and kindness, dimmed into lifeless orbs. We hunters watched in helpless horror as our beloved king breathed his last. His noble sacrifice, a symbol of his unwavering devotion to Ravenswood. The Alpha Werewolf, sated by his gruesome feast, let out a triumphant howl that echoed through the shattered castle. With the king's death, the battle seemed to lose its fervor. The werewolves, their leader's hunger appeased, retreated into the shadows, leaving behind a scene of devastation and sorrow. We gathered around King Frederick's lifeless form, our hearts heavy with grief. The moon hung overhead, an unfeeling witness to the tragedy that had befallen our kingdom. The loss of our beloved ruler was a wound that would never fully heal, and our fight against the encroaching darkness had cost us dearly. As we mourned our fallen king, we knew that our struggle was far from over. The Alpha Werewolf and his pack still roamed the night, their hunger for blood unsated. We were battered and grieving, but we remained determined to protect our village, to honor King Frederick's memory, and to confront the darkness that had befallen us. In the wake of King Frederick's tragic demise, our resolve burned brighter than ever. We hunters, weary and bloodied, knew that the Alpha Werewolf and his pack still haunted the shadows of our village. It was a battle we could not shirk, for Ravenswood's fate rested in our hands. The moon, a silent sentinel above, cast its ethereal light upon the village, illuminating the scarred ruins of the castle. We moved with purpose, tracking the elusive werewolves to their lair, guided by the memory of our fallen king and the desperate need to protect our home. The Alpha Werewolf's lair was a cavern hidden deep within the forest, a place of primal dread where the boundaries between man and beast blurred. We approached with caution, our weapons at the ready, the weight of our mission bearing heavily upon us. The cavern's entrance was an ominous maw, the abyss from which our nightmares had sprung. The stench of the pack's presence hung heavy in the air, a nauseating mix of fur and blood that stung our senses. As we ventured deeper into the darkness, the cavern widened into a foreboding chamber. Bones, both animal and human, littered the floor like grim trophies of past conquests. The air was thick with tension, our every breath a reminder of the peril that surrounded us. Then, from the shadows emerged the Alpha Werewolf, his massive form a grotesque specter in the dim light. His eyes, twin orbs of malevolence, locked onto us with a predatory hunger that sent shivers down our spines. He was a creature of nightmares, a force of darkness and death. Without hesitation, the Alpha Werewolf lunged at us, his claws slashing through the air. Eric, our steadfast sentinel, met the beast's charge with a fierce determination. Their clash was a whirlwind of fur and steel, a deadly dance that reverberated through the cavern. Hans, ever the cunning tactician, launched a volley of arrows at the oncoming pack, his aim true as they found their marks. The werewolves howled in agony, their ranks thinned by our relentless assault. Anna, the youngest among us, fought with a newfound courage, her bowstring singing as she released arrow after arrow. She stood at the periphery of the battle, her keen eyes searching for an opening in the pack's defenses. I, too, joined the fray, my blade flashing in the moonlight as I struck at the Alpha Werewolf's flank. The creature's howls of pain were a testament to our determination, but he fought on with a relentless fury. The battle raged on, a symphony of steel and fur, blood and fire. With each strike, we drew closer to victory, closer to reclaiming our village from the grip of darkness. But the Alpha Werewolf, a force of malevolence that refused to yield, fought with a ferocity that defied reason. With a final, desperate lunge, he sought to tear into our ranks, to claim one last victim before succumbing to the relentless assault. In that critical moment, Anna's arrow found its mark, piercing the Alpha Werewolf's heart. He let out a guttural, anguished howl, a sound that echoed through the cavern as his monstrous form crumpled to the ground. The pack, bereft of their leader, retreated into the darkness, their crimson eyes filled with terror and defeat. We stood victorious, our breaths ragged and our bodies battered, but our village was safe once more. As the moon cast its final silvery rays upon the scene, we hunters knew that our struggle was not in vain. Ravenswood, though scarred by darkness, would rise again, and our fallen king's legacy would live on. With heavy hearts and a solemn determination, we left the cavern behind, our village's future uncertain, but filled with hope. The battle was over, but the war against the encroaching darkness would continue, under the watchful gaze of the moon, as we forged a path toward a brighter dawn. As the sun dipped below the horizon, casting long shadows across the room, I settled into the old, weathered chair. Beside me, the fireplace crackled, casting a warm, flickering light that danced upon the faces of my wide-eyed grandchildren. Their eager eyes glistened with anticipation as they nestled closer, their small forms wrapped in blankets. "Tell us a story, Grandfather," young Emily whispered, her voice filled with wonder. I smiled, my heart brimming with love for these precious souls. "Ah, my little ones," I began, my voice a soft, melodious cadence. "I have a tale to share. A tale of a village known as Ravenswood." Their eyes widened, and I knew I had their undivided attention. With each word, I wove the tapestry of the story, painting vivid images of moonlit hunts, courageous hunters, and the encroaching darkness that had threatened our beloved village. As I spoke of the battles fought and the sacrifices made, their faces mirrored a myriad of emotions: fear, awe, and hope. They gasped in unison when I revealed the fate of Elara and the noble king who had stood as a beacon of strength. "And so, my dear ones," I concluded, my voice filled with the weight of history and wisdom, "Ravenswood emerged from the abyss, its people stronger and united. The darkness had been vanquished, and the village stood as a symbol of hope and resilience." Their young hearts were filled with the essence of the tale, and they sat in silence, absorbing the lessons it held. But I wasn't finished, for there was one last revelation to share. "Would you like to know a secret?" I asked, leaning closer. Their eyes sparkled with curiosity. "Yes, Grandfather," they chorused. I leaned back, my gaze fixed on the twinkling stars outside the window. "You see," I began, my voice a whisper, "I was there, in Ravenswood, all those years ago. I was one of the hunters who faced the darkness, who fought to protect our home." Their gasps of astonishment were music to my ears, and I couldn't help but chuckle. "Yes, it's true," I said, a twinkle in my eye. "I was a young man back then, facing the most harrowing trials of my life. But I learned that courage can be found even in the darkest of times, and that love, unity, and hope can drive back even the most fearsome of monsters." Their faces lit up with understanding, and they leaned in even closer, eager for more. "And so," I continued, "the story of Ravenswood lives on, passed down through the generations. It's a story of strength, resilience, and the enduring spirit of a village that refused to surrender to the shadows." As I concluded the tale, I could see in their young eyes the flicker of a flame, the spark of hope and determination. The story of Ravenswood had become more than a tale. It had become a legacy, a reminder that no matter how dark the night, there would always be those who would stand against it, driven by the light of love and courage. And so, as the firelight danced upon their faces, I knew that the story of Ravenswood would continue to live on, passed down through the ages, a testament to the indomitable spirit of those who dared to confront the darkness and emerge victorious.